Brother Pastor Major, we were discussing a little bit about the dangers of modern translations. What would you say is the biggest problem with modern translations today?
Right. Well, there are two problems with modern translations today. Number one, they are using the wrong text. And so that's an issue of the TR, or the Textus Receptus, the received text, which is what our King James Bible is based upon, versus the critical text. And the TR, the Textus Receptus, of course, has over 5,000 manuscripts behind it that it is based upon and translated from, whereas the critical text only has primarily just two texts that it is based upon, the Vaticanus and the Sinaiticus. And those two texts, of course, are corrupt. The Vaticanus coming from the Vatican, we don't trust anything the Roman Catholic Church says. And then the Sinaiticus was a text that has been obviously corrupted. Things change in it. You can tell it's been marked throughout the Sinaiticus, and so it's been corrupted. And then number two, the second problem is the problem of how it is translated. You know, our Bibles, our King James Bibles, are translated with formal equivalence, meaning that it is translated word for word. What did God say, and how do we translate that, say it word for word in the English? Whereas most of your modern versions today are translated with dynamic equivalence, which is translating the word of God, not word for word, but thought for thought, idea for idea, which leaves it open to the opinions of man. And so you get man's opinion. Well, this is what we think God said. I don't want what I think, what some man thinks God said. I want what did God say.
Amen. Amen. Brother Greg.
So, yeah, and even just speaking about the two critical texts, you have the Sinaiticus and Vaticanus, even amongst themselves, they disagree with each other on thousands of accounts. You see additions and subtractions. You can actually see where words are removed and they're still faintly there and then just written over top of again. So there's obviously a problem underlying that text. Even if they did a perfect word-for-word translation of the wrong text, it's still a wrong text. So the basis, the foundation for those texts is wrong.
Right. I like to describe it like this. I want a translated Bible, not an interpreted Bible. There's a big difference. I don't want you to interpret it for me. Those are called commentaries. Modern, and one thing to remember, if you're out there, and we'll be addressing some of these questions in a little bit, but if you're out there wondering which Bible, you know, there's just so many English Bibles, well, just go back to the method of translation. One, where did it come from? Was it the Textus Receptus, or we'll often refer to it as the TR, or the critical text? And those, all modern Bibles come from English, come from the critical text. And there's a few that do come from the TR, and we're going to cover that here in a little bit as well. But the ones that are coming from the critical text, they're not even faithful to the text. They don't believe the text matters. They don't believe that the words of God are inspired. You will not find a new international version user saying, these are the inspired and